What's going on, guys? The Comics Kid 2099 here to examine Marvel Team Up issue 23. This issue is written by Len Wein with penciling by Gil Kane, inking by Mike Esposito, coloring by Glynis Wein, lettering by C. Jeter, that is Charlotte Jeter, who I believe worked on one of the issues of Amazing Adventures featuring the Beast, and edited by Roy Thomas. So this issue is not collected in Essential Classic X-Men Volume 3. That is where most of the post X-Men Issue 66 X-Men guest appearances have been collected, but this is collected in Essential Marvel Team-Up Volume 1, which I happen to have. So basically, Spider-Man told the Human Torch that there was a prowler at a jewelry store that he tried to stop, and then he wasn't able to stop this guy, and then Spider-Man had to go and do something else. This issue does advertise giant-sized Spider-Man Issue 1. This is the mid-70s, so there were a lot of giant-sized issues out there, giant-sized creatures, giant-sized Spider-Man, the upcoming giant-sized X-Men, giant-sized Man-Thing. There were a lot of giant-sized issues. That was a thing Marvel was trying out at this time. So Human Torch says he's bored, so he wants to see if he can find the prowler that escaped from Spider-Man. And then he is at the jewelry store, and then a ice ball hits him in the back, and so he thinks, well, that's got to be Iceman. And then he sees Iceman flying around, and then he attacks Iceman. Iceman says he doesn't know what Torch is talking about. They fight for a few pages, and then the X-Men show up in their original uniforms again. I don't know why they're not wearing their more up-to-date uniforms, and also, we once again do not see Polaris or Havoc here. We have barely seen them at all since X-Men 66. I think one time in an issue of Hulk we saw them. Every other time the team has shown up, Polaris and Havoc have not been there. And once again, they're not here. Cyclops tells Iceman, we've been looking all over for you. We have a very important mission. I believe this is a mission that we will see referenced when we get to Giant Size X-Men Issue 1. But then Iceman says, I can't go with you guys yet. I've got to find whoever it is that tried to frame me for robbing a jewelry store. So the X-Men just leave. I don't know why they can't help Iceman. But the Human Torch, he says that he will help Torch. And then they find a guy who has Torch's powers and Iceman's powers. His name is Equinox, the Thermodynamic Man. And basically, he stole an atomic clock that was at the jewelry store. I don't know why there was an atomic clock at the jewelry store, and I don't really know why he needed the atomic clock. This guy says that he needed to cure himself, and then Iceman and Torch, they fight him for a little while, and then he either escapes or he dies. At first, they're thinking that he died, that he just disappeared, but then they see there's a hole in the ground that leads into the sewers beneath the city, so it's possible that he escaped. And I looked it up, and this guy does show up again in some other comics later on. And that's about it. This issue is okay. We get to see Iceman and Torch actually work together, which is not what we got to see when we talked about Marvel Team-Up Issue 4, but this issue spends so much time on Torch thinking that Iceman was trying to rob a jewelry store that I feel like it wastes a lot of that space. I feel like we could have gotten to these two teaming up a little earlier so that we could have maybe gotten a little more information on Equinox. Why is he doing what he's doing? How does he think that he can cure himself of his powers? Where did he get his powers? There's a lot of unanswered questions about this bad guy, because I think the issue realizes we don't have any time to answer those questions because we spent so much time setting up Human Torch. He's talking to Spider-Man, then he goes back to headquarters. He's ruminating about the state of things with the Fantastic Four. Apparently Reed and Sue are having trouble with their marriage, and then he decides to go to the jewelry store, and then that's when he thinks he's attacked by Iceman. It takes a while for these two to actually say, okay, let's work together and find out who is trying to frame you. I wish we could have, gotten to that point a little quicker, and then maybe we could have gotten a little bit more of a satisfactory explanation for who Equinox is and what he's doing and why he's doing it. So overall, this is just kind of a really elongated fight scene. One big fight scene between Torch and Iceman, and then one big fight scene between those two and Equinox. And it's okay, but I feel like this issue lacks a lot of substance. So that is about it for this. I will be examining something else next week. In the meantime, I hope you guys have a great rest of the day, and I will see you guys later. Let's consider this issue examined.